does Boston rate on a scale of 1 to 10 as far as hating goals, man?
Hating?
Hating. Of course. Compared to any other city or state you've been to.
Boston hates. Terribly.
It'd
be a motherfucker that know your mom
moves.
I'm gonna give you one better than that. Niggas hating on me, right? I'm an individual and I'm a soldier. And in order for me to have become such a great leader, I was once a great follower. Period. I just didn't follow the route them niggas did with that get high shit and all that sucker shit. I knew how to put my money in certain places. And it ain't too many niggas in this town that didn't fuck with me on different levels, and they ate. So once me, I'm so clever. I know how to sit back and watch niggas kill themselves. I don't have to sit down and do 15 over you. You're a goofy. You understand what I'm saying to you? Go ahead. Somebody that got less to lose, less to live for, gonna knock your wig off, and I'm gonna sit back and smile. Really? You feel what I'm saying to you? But that hate shit, niggas hate on me and don't even fucking know me, man.
Don't even know you.
Grew up looking at me ride through and everything else. I done fuck with their brothers, or they might have been mad. I might have touched their girlfriend or something. I don't know. I don't know what the fuck the problem is. I don't care either, to be honest. Because nobody calls me and address me Dolo. They can only address me in the squad, you feel me? But that tells me what size man I am. If you can't confront me like a man, Dolo, Bolo, then Chuck, I got a problem with you because of whatever. Nigga, because you don't have a fucking problem with me. I don't fuck with half of you chump ass niggas. So how would you have a problem? You know what I tell a nigga, man? I know where to find you at. It's all good. You're going to be right in the hood, Jack. You don't have no vision. You don't have a vision. Once you don't have a vision, where you going? You don't have a vision, where the fuck are you going? In order for you to become a great guy, you got to be under the right tutelage, man. Hopefully, when they hear me on this motherfucking DVD that I'm doing for one of the homies, they can appreciate what I'm saying. And if they don't do nothing else, watch it at home by yourself. That way your ego won't get involved, and you'll know that everything that I'm saying is the truth. I'm not up here bigging up my motherfucking self. It is what it is. Ray Dog. I say Ray Dog. I say it. I didn't come from up under Ray Dog. You remember that. So, had he came to me, I've been aftermath for 8 years. I brought the niggas Eminem. I brought Dre back, more importantly. Also, last nigga I signed over there was Gang. That's like 4 million, so, right, go check this out. Fuck all that. Had he came to me like a boss, you gotta be a boss first. Come to me as a boss and said, let's join forces, when the source was something, and I was where I was. I had the West Coast smash. They had media and everything else on smash with this magazine. Had they came to me, we'd have been a superpower, unstoppable. But when a motherfucker's afraid of the next man making himself powerful, then they don't want to do it. I went out there, Dolo, myself, when niggas from the East was getting murdered for being on the West Coast. They had just killed the nigga Pac. Right after that, they killed a nigga Big. I'm out there with nigga, you better not have been from nowhere but California, or you'd get your fucking head knocked off. Period. I'm out there then. The niggas didn't want to come to me and say, yo, dog, let's do this like this and put it together. We'd have been good. I don't give a fuck. The Dave made shit, okay. I would show Dave how to keep money. And I would have let Ray do what the fuck he do. Go on and ball out of control. Have you do what you got to do. But we would have been all right over here. We would have never fell off. Because I got relationships for 20 years. You understand what I'm saying to you? So, I don't know. I don't understand why. I don't understand. We did a couple of things. We did a couple of records. I got the hottest producer in the country right now, Nephew. It's my nephew. I got mine, so I'm Be Nasty. You know what I mean? We got the hottest motherfuckers. It's undeniable that we got the hottest niggas, period. And it would have been good to be able to come through and catch a couple of talented motherfuckers and did some music for him on his strength. So they can position themselves. Niggas hate so fast. And they hate the wrong individual.
One day I was doing a little session like this, and we were speaking about, you know, Benzino guy. You know, Rado.
Right,
yeah, we were speaking about Ray, you know, and somebody out the cut, you know, said, you know, why is everybody always jumping on Ray? This, that, and the third. How come ain't nobody never said nothing about Fat Chuck?
Not to go too crazy, you know, I'm so crazy, right, with trying to help motherfuckers since they want to say what Big Chuck is. I bring a nigga that I ain't never fucked with this nigga. I'm doing this thing called Rep Your Set, right? 27 of the most notorious gangs, like why these niggas want to say they gangbangers out here. 27 of the most notorious gangs in Los Angeles. So I bring a nigga from Boston, that's of course, but you know, niggas from Boston, they want to overdo it. For some reason, they want to bring the parquet floor and Larry Bird's cell phone number. They want to do too much for me. I'm saying shut the fuck up, do what you gotta do, you dig me?
Yeah.
Bring my man out there, shit go haywire. So I try to help the community. I just need the community to try to help me. Let's get out here and get some motherfucking money, man. Don't feel too big to follow me, man. I'm not gonna mislead you, Jack. That's one thing you got to understand. I'm not gonna mislead my people, bottom line. Because they don't even really know the science of where that source money came from. Real talk. Alright, so they can say the fuck they want to. I just choose not to get indicted with the rest of the group. Period. So, them wanting to talk about me, talk about me. I don't give a fuck. They don't go nowhere further than Boston. Period. Niggas know me and love me around the motherfucking globe. And you might say the wrong thing and a nigga chop your wig off. Period. Period. Now, who do I owe? Who do Ray owe? Ray chose to help a lot of niggas that he didn't even really get in the bed with. Which is okay. And certain niggas that he grew up with, he couldn't intertwine with for whatever reason. Can't be mad at that. A motherfucker don't owe you nothing. Nigga, I did one Source ad interview, right? 15 years later. 15 years later. Niggas can say what the fuck they want to. Niggas can say Big T was they man. And Shut the fuck up. Ain't man nigga dead over what happened to Tom. First and foremost, to all the riders and the riding dies and I bust my gun and all that, save it. Shut the fuck up with that bullshit. Let's not talk about that. Secondly, motherfucker don't have a relationship with his mother. Thirdly, motherfucker got his son out the street wild and acting crazy so something can happen to him and he end up where his dad is. So that shows you how much genuine love they had for that man, period. Period. I don't want to hear nothing them niggas are saying. All them niggas just want to be pointed in directions. They don't know how, it's like a fucking addict. They don't know how to come and ask for help, man. They don't know how to come and ask for help, man. These niggas won't humble themselves, and that's the reason why they're not gonna grow. Period. Reason why they can't stop me is because they cannot think me.